In this tutorial, we will solve some sheet metal exercises based on what we learned in previous tutorial. We will be creating this object and this object. We will start with this object. Click on New, select the part. Okay. Then to bring the sheet metal toolbar, right click on the ribbon bar and select sheet metal. Then drag the toolbar and place it wherever you want it. At first we will create this plate of 180 by 100 using base flange tab. Click on base flange tab, select the plane. As we want to create this part as vertical, we will select front plane. Click on front plane. Then create a rectangle from center point, center rectangle. Then place the dimension using smart dimension. Give the location. Give the length of 180. And width of 100. Then click on OK. Then give here the thickness. Sheet metal thickness is 1.2. And inner bend radius is 1. Give the thickness of 1.2. Then OK. Then click on this sheet metal. Click on this edit feature and set the inner radius to be 1. So 1 is already there. Click on OK. Then next is to create this edge flange of 50 length. Click on edge flange. Select this edges. Give the length point. Select bottom edge. Give the edge point. Then total length is 50 from the bottom. Give here the length of 50 and select this outer virtual sharp. We already have created the object of 100 width and this edge flange should be within that width. Therefore, we will click here material inside. So it will maintain the width and click on OK. We can check that whether the width is 100 by clicking on this evaluate and click on this measure. Select this surface and select this surface. The length is 100. And we can also check the height of 50. Click on measure, select this surface and this surface. And here we can check that normal distance is 50. Then next is to create the mitre flange. We need to create the mitre flange on these lines. Mitre flange, select on the upper side. Then click on normal to. Then create one line from the external point. Then give the smart dimension, give the length. The length of mitre flange is 15 from the bottom. Give here 15, enter, then click on OK. Then the gap distance is 0.5. Here is the 0.5 distance is there. Then we need to maintain the length. Therefore, click here material inside so that the original length will not increase. Then orbit it and click on this propagate. So it will propagate to remaining lines. Then click on OK. Then click on this plane 3 and hide it. Then we will need to create these holes on it. Click here simple hole. Click on the surface where you want to create it. Then give the diameter. Diameter of the hole is 4. Link to thickness. Diameter is 4. Then click on OK. Then to give the position to the hole, click on the hole and click on edit sketch. From outer edge it is 9, from upper edge it is 10. Click on smart dimension, take the outside edge and the center point and give the length of 9. And select the upper edge to the center point and give the length of 10. Then click on OK. Then same hole are repeated here. Same size of holes. We will pattern this hole. Click on the hole. Click on the linear pattern. And make it normal to. Give the direction one. Click this vertical line. And make it reverse to go down. Then give the gap between the atoms. 50 minus 9 is 41. That means this gap is 41. Here give the spacing of 41. Enter. Then click on this direction 2. Give this line as a direction 2. Then again reverse it, give the number of atoms to be 2. 2 is correct. Then the gap between the atom is again 50 minus 19, that means 31. Then give the gap of 31. Enter. Then we don't want to view some holes. Click on these instances to skip and click on these holes. Then click on OK. Then we need the same portion on other side, so we will mirror it. Click on mirror, then select the plane, right plane. Then features to mirror will be this pattern, hole, mitre flange. Then click on OK. Then next is to create this cut of 20 by 40. Click on extrude cut. Then select this backside face. Then click on normal to. Then create one rectangle. Then click on smart dimension. It is 30, 20, 40, 30. Give the dimension from outer edge 30. And this width is 20. Then this height is 40. And from this outer edge is again 30. Then next is to create these chamfers of 5 by 2.5. Click here, select chamfer. Then from here choose the distance and remove the tick. Equal distance. Here you give 2.5 and here 5. Enter. Then 2.5 is for the first edge. Select this as a first edge. Zoom it. And this as a second edge. Again this as a first, second. Then click on OK. Then OK. Then link to thickness and OK. This object is ready. Then click on new. Select part. OK. Next part is this one. Now this part we will create using different method. In this, at first we will create this C shape with 80 by 140 dimension. Click on base flange tab. Now we want this part to be vertical. Therefore click on this front plane. Then click on line and create the C shape. Then give the smart dimension. Here it is 80 and here it is 140. Zoom fit, escape, then select this line, control this line and make them equal. Okay. Then give the thickness. Here the thickness is 3 and radius is 1. The thickness is 3 is there and radius is 1 is also there. Then from here click on this direction one and give the length. We will extrude the half and then afterwards we will mirror complete body. So here it will give 75. Here it is 75. Enter. We will just see its front view. We want this material to be inside because we have given the external dimension. Click on this tick, reverse direction, so it will go inside. And click on OK. Then next is to create this mitre flange. Here is the size is 8 and we want it on these lines. Click on mitre flange, click on this line and near this end. Then click on normal to and create one line. Smart dimension, give the length to be 8. Then OK. Orbit it and click on this propagate. Then gap we will keep it 0.25 and we want material to be inside. Then click on OK. Hide this plane, click on the plane one and hide. Then we will mirror it on the other side. Click on features, mirror, then select the mirror plane. We want to mirror around this surface. Then features to mirror. Actually we want to mirror complete body, therefore we will click on this bodies to mirror and click on this body and click on OK. Then next is to create this tab. It is of 20 plus 30 50 size and width is 100 at this position in the center. Click on this base flange tab, select this surface, make it normal, Then create one rectangle from this point to this point. And give the smart dimension. The length is 100 and width is 50. Then we want it to be symmetric around center. Create one center line. Escape. Then select this line, control this line and center line. Then click on symmetric. Okay. Then okay. Orbit it and click on OK. Then next is want to bend it at a height of 20 with material inside. For that we will use this sketch bend. Click on sketch bend, select this surface, then create one line here, right click, select. Then give the smart dimension from this line to this line is 20. And click on OK. This will be the fixed face. Then we want material to be inside 90 degrees, correct, click on OK. Then we can check the distance. We need this distance to be 20. Click on this evaluate, measure, click on this face to this face. So normal distance is 20, vertical distance is 20, that is correct. Then next is to create this cut. For this we will have to unfold this bend here. Click on this unfold, select the fixed surface. Then select the bend to unfold and click on OK. Then again click on this extruded cut, select this surface, make it normal, normal to. Then create one rectangle and give the dimension 60, 40, 20. Smart dimension from outside to this line is 60. Then length of this line is 20 and from this line to this line is 40. Then click on OK. Orbit it, link to thickness, OK. Then we will have to fold it back. Click on this fold, then click on bend to fold this bend, click on OK. And click on isometric view. Thanks for watching. We will stop here.